Hello everybody, my name is Kim. So have you been thinking about becoming a web developer but don't know where to start? Why don't you just join with me and understand a little bit better, hands-on experience what exactly back-end, front-end, and full-stack developer like on a day-to-day basis? And I will also talk a little bit about some courses that you may consider if you want to become a web developer.
Samples, UIs for a website? So this is basically on the right side, you see this is like a final product that a user will be able to see on the website. For example, if the user is posting any status, then the role of front-end developer will make sure that everything was laid out pretty beautiful and they do any highlight in the wording and make sure that all of the icons is working. So and especially for this box radius, like see it is a square or we have some radius in the box and some shadows. That is actually a role of the front-end developer. They make sure that everything is look beautiful so that the user will be happy to use the products right away. So what kind of language that do you use? So the front-end developer usually use a framework called React, which is basically a JavaScript language. So there's a different types of functional component that was used using React, and they will use a React to render one of the list meshes that is built from the database. So right now the role of the backend developers will come in handy is that they are the person who actually taking the information from the user and build the database. So let's say they build a storage where the user put in the all of the information. Like for example, they post on the status for their social account, and the backend will be able to get that information and then store it somewhere in the cloud maybe, or at the database levels. And after that, the front-end developer will be able to take this information and write out a layout, a beautiful website for the user to use. So that is like a simple term of a tech stack that a company usually use. But also like some of the language is pretty popular for the backend is Python, Django, and Node.js. Those are like the most popular language right now that when I go apply for different roles, I see this pop ups a lot. Alright, so basically we have a little bit of understanding about how it works, how the website looks like, and what is their roles are. So why don't we go ahead and see what is the different resources that can utilize for you to get started on your web development journey. So the first course that I can find is really interesting is from Udemy website. This is where it hosts a lot of different category in the website I will see. This course is created by Dr. Angela Yus. I really like her because of her personality, and in the past I learned about iOS development from this instructor, so it's really good content and the way that she teach me a lot about personality I should have to become a developer. So for this course, it's 120 hours to complete the course. Why is that? Because when you look at the video, you also need extra time to debug yourself, try to figure out what went wrong, and whether you understand the material, you might stop, pause the videos, and go back to the material and try to solve the problem by yourself. So this is pretty time consuming, but eventually when you finish the courses, you will definitely have a lot of understanding about HTML, CSS, Bootstrap to build a web development, and why they use JavaScript ES6. And also there's a lot of basic knowledge in JavaScript, let's say data type structure, what is incremental and decremental in JavaScript, and some of the final product that you can take away from here is you will be able to build different kind of calculator from this course. And move to the next course. It is a complete JavaScript course 2022. This course actually I took it in the past when I just started development. The reason why I really like this course is it really teaches me a lot about fundamental of JavaScript. Everything is from scratch. Anything related to what is an arrow function, what is OP, and what is the difference between using a class component and functional component, and what kind of pathway that I can use when I finish the course. This is took a very long time to finish because it's like 70 hours plus extra 100 to 120 hours for your own time. So definitely it's a really huge commitment for this course. But the takeaway is you will be able to understand all of the fundamentals that you need to become a good developer from JavaScript fundamental, and learning how to use Google Maps to build a website for your own as well, using geolocation. I really like this course, and I'm quickly show you the final website that I learned after learning the course is that I'm able to build some of these simple websites for the banking system. Let's say when you go to local bank, you'll be able to open your bank account, see different features on the website and how much loan that you have balancing, and some additional advertisement make the website look really beautiful, and also some customer review as well. And last but not least, we need to do a sign up for the account if we really interested in the website. Yeah, so the key takeaway is here is take a lot of time to build a skill, but then when you finish building it, you all have the projects on hand that you comfortably can apply for a job or even start building a website for your own as well. Last but not least, the course is really highly popular right now. The fact is that React is a framework developed based on JavaScript, and if you look at a lot of job description right now, is it the most popular language for the front-end developer. Here, you will be able to have a lot of chance to learn different hook React, what is React router, and what is the stage of a React app could be. So React is basically a framework. You can use it to build a web app and a website with some simple JavaScript. This course is less hours than the previous course I just introduced, only 48 hours. And there's like a lot of interesting topic here that I think is really important, especially if you go for your first few interview. You need to know React stage and like React component. What does it mean? Because during the interview, they might ask you to a lot of questions, like say why you use React hook or how to implement that in the app. If you learn the course, definitely you have a lot of good knowledge and be really confident going to your first interview. Let me know how you like it and feel free to subscribe to my channel. So it helped me to get motivated and create more interesting contents for the audience. Thank you so much and see you in the next video.